years ago, I heard a phrase that changed my life, really. I was sitting at a campfire in Central Africa, and the phrase was this: 13 dead gorillas. I didn't realize at the time, but that phrase was launching me on a long quest. It was a quest to understand the ecology and evolutionary biology of scary viruses. Does a virus even have an ecology? Yeah. Can a virus evolve? Yes. Why should we care? Because those subjects relate to the matter of whether tens of millions of people might die in the next new pandemic disease. This quest took me out of my comfort zone. My comfort zone up until then was big critters, writing about critters that you can see. And then I found myself in this at this particular campfire. We were in the midst of a forest in northeastern Gabon, and these two local guys were talking about Ebola virus. They were talking about the time Ebola struck their village, not very many miles from where we were sitting. It was a terrible outbreak, killed dozens of their loved ones and friends in hideous ways. They seemed traumatized by the memories, but I was prying the story out of them. And then one of them said, you know, besides all the death and misery in the village, there was something else, something strange right at that time, something we saw. It was a pile of 13 dead gorillas lying nearby in the forest. 13 dead gorillas in a pile. I think my mouth fell open. I wrote the phrase in my notebook. I already knew a bit about Ebola, and one thing I knew is that it kills gorillas and chimps as well as humans. But hearing that phrase from them in the midst of Ebola habitat made the whole thing more immediate. It was the beginning of my quest to understand something called zoonoses. Zoonoses. Kind of a technical term, but it's easy to define. A zoonosis is an animal infection transmissible to humans. Might be a virus like Ebola or Marburg. Might be a bacterium like the bug responsible for Lyme disease. Once it gets into humans, if it takes hold and causes sickness, we call that a zoonotic disease. Now, this is not a small subject at the weird fringe of medicine. This is central. 60% of the infectious diseases known among humans are zoonotic. Bubonic plague is a zoonotic disease. It passes from rodents into people. AIDS is a disease of zoonotic origin, caused by a virus that passed from a single chimpanzee into a single human back around 1908, give or take a margin of error. Hendra is a very nasty zoonotic virus that falls out of bats into horses, killing them, and then goes from horses into people, killing them. These zoonoses, for all their bad effects, serve one valuable purpose. They remind us of the connectedness between humans and other species. And one form of that connectedness is shared disease. Animal disease, human disease, same disease. So just thinking about zoonoses tends to reaffirm the old Darwinian truth, and it's probably the darkest of his truths, that we humans are animals. We're part of nature. We're not separate from it or somehow above it. There are a lot of new entries to the grim list of zoonoses. Most of them are viruses. They've emerged and caused outbreaks one after another over the last 5 or 6 decades. Machupo in Bolivia, 1961. Marburg, related to Ebola, 1967. Ebola itself hit the radar screens in 1976. HIV, first recognized 1981. Hanta in America, 1993. Hendra in Australia, 1994. Bird flu, Hong Kong, 1997. Nipah virus in Malaysia, 1998. West Nile, New York, 1999. And SARS coming out of southern China, 2003. You get the picture. It's been a drumbeat of new viruses emerging over recent years. If they're emerging, emerging from where? Every new zoonotic disease starts as a mystery story. We can guess that the infection crosses into humans from some other animal, but which animal? Another technical term here. Any species in which a zoonotic bug lives permanently, inconspicuously, without causing symptoms, is known as the reservoir host. Bats are the reservoir host for Hendra virus. The reservoir host of Ebola is still undiscovered. But we know that Marburg, Ebola's cousin, also has its reservoir in bats. And the Hanta viruses come to us from rodents. Okay, one final bit of terminology. When a zoonotic bug passes from its reservoir host into its first human victim, that event is called spillover. Jeffrey Platt in an isolation ward. Spillover. Okay, so now you've got the basics, the crucial ideas, and the key terms. Zoonosis, reservoir host, spillover. With that much, you understand more about the future of infectious disease than 99% of the human population. Pat yourselves on the back and get a flu shot in November. Why are all these spillovers occurring? Why are some of them quickly circling the world? I can answer in two words: disruption and connectivity. More and more, we humans are disrupting the wild, diverse ecosystems that harbor so many different kinds of creature. And for each species of animal or plant in those places, there's probably at least one unique form of virus. All of our logging and burning and road building and settlement and killing and eating of bushmeat, all of those actions tend to shake loose new viruses from the reservoir hosts, giving them the opportunity to infect humans instead. Disruption. And once they infect us, once they enter, replicate, adapt, and find ways to transmit from human to human, they can travel at the speed of an airplane, killing millions of people along the way. 7 years ago, National Geographic asked me to do a story on this subject. They sent me back to Central Africa, sent me to a number of other places. That magazine assignment turned into a book project, and the book was finally published last autumn. It's a compendium of gruesome stories and scientific ideas, but it's also the tale of this quest, my quest to understand the dynamics and the human realities of zoonotic diseases. From the campfire in Central Africa until this afternoon, that quest has consumed 12 years, 8 months, and 11 days. I haven't added up the miles. But the real effort has just begun. The real effort involves trying to persuade you and other people of the deeper meaning of zoonotic disease. The deeper meaning is more than just preventing human illness. It goes back to that basic Darwinian truth. The deeper meaning is that people and gorillas, chimps and monkeys and horses, rodents and bats and viruses, we are all in this together. Thank you.